that the epic battles against Spurs must end tonight. If it's needed, there will be extra time and penalties here at White Hart Lane. So Spurs seek a place in the Littlewoods Cup final, knowing that they need to get past Arsenal at this third attempt to get there. Another crowd estimated around 40,000 here. It means that something like 120,000 fans have seen the three matches so far. The overall take at the gate will reach £750,000 tonight. And when everything's taken into account, it goes past the £1 million mark. The team news then. Well, there have been stories today that Glenn Hoddle may miss the match with a stomach muscle injury. They were right. Hoddle is out. And Spurs will miss his skill and vision, although his replacement in the number 10 shirt, Gary Stevens, is an international, a strong-running, competitive midfield man. The rest of the Tottenham side, unchanged. As for Arsenal, they are unchanged. They start with the team that began the game on Sunday, and they come with confidence. They've won here at White Hart Lane twice already in 1987. Our referee tonight, Joe Worrell of Warrington. So, episode 3 of this continuing and gripping saga gets underway. Arsenal in red and white shirts attacking the goal to our right. And Ray Clements with the clearance. And Arsenal, after their superb performance here on Sunday, a great comeback after being 2 down on aggregate. Might even feel that the pendulum might just have swung their way a little, even though Spurs have home advantage. A free kick to Tottenham in, Ardila's with it. Waddle, putting the ball in there. It was Kenny Sansom's head that got it away. Ardila's again. Backdrop again to this epic cup tie. A huge wall of noise. Side flag was up. Referee playing on with Goff in possession for Tottenham. Allen's little touch for Ardiles. And again, the Arsenal back four this time pushing up very quickly, catching Spurs offside. Two sides who now know so much about each other, cancelling each other out in so many quarters. Both the games so far have been so tight and fully committed, and you really have to expect the same tonight. Sanson, Quinn, being watched by Mabbott, but he's shaken him off. Chance for Arsenal here, across the face of the goal, and a glorious chance for Arsenal to snatch a lead in the second minute of the game, when Niall Quinn, the big 6'4" Irishman, shook off the attentions of Gary Mabbott. There's Mabbott losing out in that struggle. Quinn is through, Clements coming out, the ball going wide. So Thomas towards Clive Allen. Well, Klassen trying to get in as well, and might succeed! Oh, just wide! So nip and tuck by both sides. Quinn at one end, and Klassen at the other, when Arsenal for a moment looked in disarray in defence. Both Clive Allen and Nico Klassen going for this ball. There's Clive Allen. Suddenly it goes Klassen's way, and the bounce certainly goes his way. Close. Thomas. Thomas again with a throw. O'Leary stretches out his legs. It should come for Waddle. Oh, a fine save by Lukic. The linesman was flagging on the far side. Waddle can't see what was wrong with that. But it looked for a moment as though it was a serious error there by David O'Leary, really stretching out there. And it fell for Chris Waddle. Hit it first time, and a lovely piece of goalkeeping by Lukic. Quinn is certainly a big, strong man, and there's more to him than a player in the air. And a free kick given there to Arsenal. There was an infringement by Richard Goff on Niall Quinn. One or two players players on pretty thin ice at the moment. Richard Gough, who's had a good talking to from the referee for the way he's been handling Niall Quinn. And there he was again. Viv Anderson, and pounced on well. And Quinn goes in, and the Spurs players protect their goalkeeper and remonstrate with the referee for the way that the big Arsenal number 9 came in on Ray Clements. It was Anderson's header. Here we see the header from Viv Anderson, and it was pounced on well there by Ray Clements. And if we can just move it on a little further, we'll see Niall Quinn coming in. And yes, indeed, he caught Clements on the side of the head. And Quinn being called back by the referee, which is interesting. And a shake of the hands, and Ray Clements, a great old campaigner at 38 years old, has been through a lot of battles before and is sporting enough to say shake hands and let's forget it. Serve to turn the screw just a little tighter on this cup tie. Clive Allen, little seen of him yet with half an hour gone, no score. Finding his cousin Paul Allen. Oh, he's tricked his man well. Looking to get across in, and it might come for Waddle! Into the side netting. Took it quickly and hit the side netting after some great work there by Paul Allen. A ricochet that took it off the Arsenal player. Thomas. Anderson. Allen to Mitchell Thomas. Puts Gary Stevens in the clear. Nice turn by him. Chris Waddle. Clive Allen on the far side. Klassen has gone through the middle. And Lukic was stopped it, but the flag was off. Really exciting move that by Tottenham. Pulled back in the end by the offside flag. Waddle picking out Klassen, who'd made a brilliant run. Another free kick for Arsenal. Foul on Quinn by Gough. You can understand the problems that defenders have against this big Niall Quinn. So the last minute of the first half, interesting free kick here for Arsenal, which Martin Hayes will take. Tony Adams up as well, keeping a real close watch on Niall Quinn. Viv Anderson creeping in there as well, it was Quinn with a header! And it's being forced in! No, there was a flag up. I thought Charlie Nicholas had forced it home for a moment after Quinn and Anderson had gone up for it. But there was certainly a lack of celebration in the Arsenal side, which was the first clue. Probably pushing down on a defender there. And it'll be a free kick to Tottenham. I'm surprised you didn't hear a whistle in this game. Added on at the end of the first half. We knew it was going to be a tight old night of raw cup tie football, and that's just what we've had, but here's Ardiles. And the little back heel by him, which is one of his trademarks, didn't quite come off, and here's Martin Hayes now, getting it forward to Quinn. The touch by him this time didn't come off. Falls for Gary Stevens. And now for another Gary, Mabbott. And an offside flag to the howls of annoyance from the Tottenham fans. Klassen caught offside. A free kick to Arsenal. And still the sides are locked together in this Littlewoods Cup semi-final replay. Niall Quinn, who's caused all sorts of problems though in the Spurs defence and might have put Arsenal ahead in the opening minutes of the game, but it remains goalless at half-time. Spurs 0, Arsenal 0. splendid picture that is, and you might say that somebody's got to be over the moon here at White Hart Lane tonight as we start the second half. The match, remember, must finish here, either with extra time or with penalties at the end of extra time. As we go into the second half, it's 0-0 and Spurs get us underway. Adilis, a lot of pressure on the little Argentinian without Hoddle in this Tottenham side to find that unexpected little twist that will open up this Arsenal defence. Not succeeded against yet. And although Arsenal have yet to win their first corner of the game, you get the feeling that overall they look slightly the more competent and more comfortable side during that first 45 minutes. But here's a test for them, with Spurs getting this free kick. Waddle and Ardiles behind it. A change of plan. Ardiles with a little touch. Waddle with a deep, deep cross. And met by David O'Leary. Ardiles again. But here comes Spurs. Another Arsenal with Anderson to Martin Hayes. Well play. And a Tottenham throw. Still with Waddle, trying to curl it. And Waddle appears to have injured himself in making that shot. Just Waddle turning Paul Davis, hitting it in one. He may have stubbed his toe as he shot. He's struggling a bit. Sanson. It's Arsenal's throw. Oh, that comes through the Rocastle. He thought about hitting it first time. It's past the post for a goal kick. Certainly crossed David Rocastle's mind to whack that first time. He changed his mind, and that maybe is where he lost out. Although it looked from that picture as though Gary Stevens may have been covering that first shot. And certainly in the tunnel area, Ian Allenson doing a lot of warming up for Arsenal. I think it may be just a matter of time before he comes on. In the meantime, Tony Adams finding Kenny Sanson for Arsenal. In towards Niall Quinn. A good jump again by Mabbott. Ardiles just hooking it away. Paul Allen inviting Ardiles to try again. That's a free kick. So difficult to dispossess in that sort of situation. He seems to lean on the opponent as he's running and holding as well. And most times he gets the free kicks given his way, as indeed he has here. We're having a good free kick in there. And a chance! Dan Allen! Well, it's just about the first thing he's done on the night. Apart from one pretty unpleasant tackle that looked in the first half. Richard Goff, finished off superbly, striker style, by Clive Allen. Allenson. Adams. Mabbott and Goff between them, getting it back. Oh, there might be a chance yet. No. Arsenal claiming a penalty there, and the referee turned their appeals away. But there was an aberration there between Goff and Mabbott. are tingling out there. And this is becoming another tremendous cup tie. Davis. Allinson onside. Now here's a chance for Arsenal. Goff trying to close him down. He's got it! It's 1-1! Yet another Arsenal comeback. Yet another surprise for Tottenham. And still more jubilation for Arsenal. Davis played the home ball forward. Spurs looking for an offside there. Allinson came on. For a moment it looked as though Richard Goff had got him covered well. And then on the turn, and then squeezing it between Goff's legs and just inside the post. Agony for Tottenham, and such joy for the number 12 of Arsenal and all their fans behind Ray Clements' goal. 1-1. Extra time is beckoning. What an astonishing cup tie this has been over three quite incredible games. Look at the joy there. Quinn and Mabert. An emergency action there by the Spurs number 6. And has the balance of power swung once again Arsenal's way. They'll be furious with themselves, Spurs. It was a really sloppy goal to give away. Allinson. Oh, Thomas. Just wide. Spurs under the cosh now. And I suppose Thomas might have felt that he could have done even a bit better than that. Goff plays it forward. Danny Thomas. Now Davis. Danny Thomas, almost the first time he's ventured forward. And he's swung in a good cross. Lubic has got it. A little too close to the keeper to be really effective. Especially a big man like Lukic. Here come Arsenal. David Rowcastle with Allinson picking him out again. Now. This time, Spurs get it away with Danny Thomas to Chris Waddle. Ardiles. 4 minutes remaining. Martin Hayes is in there, but the flag is up. The flag is up. Fury on the faces of those Spurs defenders, and frustration there for Martin Hayes. The flag was up. It'll be a free kick to Tottenham. Now, what will this cup tie have next for us? Davis. Palmist man there. Centre David Pleat with the cap, the Spurs manager. But what frustration for him. He looked to be Wembley bound, and Ian Allinson has put a stop to that. It looks like extra time. Sanson, Allinson. Maybe Allinson's got other ideas. Davis. Sanson towards Quinn again, winning it in the air, but Allinson's is there. Free kick to Arsenal. O'Leary with the kick. Deep, deep one. Quinn hoping to get on the end of it. It comes for Allinson. Driven first time. It might go anywhere. Rowcastle! Arsenal are through to Wembley. whistle. Beyond Ray Clements. And Arsenal now, surely with the formality of playing out time. The referee looking at the watch. It couldn't be a more dramatic comeback than this. Can Spurs yet save it? Well, they've got to get hold of the ball first. Goff plays it forward. But Hayes now on the break, and Thomas struggling to get it back to Ray Clements. Of injury time played. What a tremendous credit to Arsenal, their persistence, their character and their courage against great odds. They've always seemed to be behind in this cup tie, and yet at the very, very last, when it matters most, it looks as though they're going to be in front. It really looks as though they are Wembley bound. Tottenham who'd be making that journey to face Liverpool. Plenty of time being added on here by referee Worrall. Rocastle getting in. A free kick to Tottenham. They're pushing everybody forward. It's a last desperate attempt now to save something from this game. 3 minutes of time added on. And the Arsenal players lining up to get that one away. I think it was Kenny Sanson who finally got the touch to it. Now Alisson running it to where it's safe as far as he's concerned. And here, Paul Allen having a little bit of a bust up. A free kick to Tottenham. Or rather a goal kick. Amazing record of Arsenal. They are through to Wembley. One of the great Littlewoods Cup comebacks. Those two late, late goals. One by Ian Allinson, and then the winner from David Rocastle. Take Arsenal through to Wembley. So, a cup tie that's been full of astonishing twists, save the most dramatic and the most savage one, right to the very end. There's the hero of the hour, David Rocastle. And the man who scored the first goal, the number 12, Ian Allinson. And Spurs have left the scene and gone up the tunnel. On a night like this, it's no place for the losers. They can't believe it. And little wonder, they look to be down and out when Clive Allen scored the number 7 for Tottenham, but it was the number 7 for Arsenal who suddenly put the Gunners through to Wembley. A final score then, here at White Hart Lane, in dramatic circumstances, Tottenham 1, Arsenal 2. And there, the Arsenal manager, George Graham, wearing what he claims to be his lucky red scarf. Well, it wasn't luck tonight. It was sheer fortitude, resilience and great determination that took George Graham's Arsenal through to Wembley. What a picture.